Back in the U.S., air quality hits unhealthy levels in Washington, D.C. due to dissipating smoke from Canada's wildfires. Washington's air quality alert was in the red zone Thursday, marking the second time this month that smoky haze has blanketed the capital. Dozens of other states were put under varying air quality alerts, affecting over 80 million Americans from the Midwest to the East Coast. Canada is currently battling its worst fire season on record, with hundreds of active wildfires raging across the country. A sweltering heat wave continues to scorch the U.S. state of Texas. Temperatures above 38 degrees Celsius are being recorded in Texas and some states in the southeast due to a weather phenomenon known as heat dome. So far, around 13 deaths are being linked to the heat wave. Some 62 million Americans are under excessive heat watches and warnings.
This is Texas. It's going to be hot. So whether we are dealing with 97 degrees or whether you're dealing with 102, hot is hot. And then, of course, when you combine that with the humidity. So with that being said, it's important that we all take the necessary precautions. Be mindful of not leaving anybody in your car, including pets. And then be mindful when we come out to celebrate the 4th of July celebrations that we come prepared.
In Mexico, at least 100 people are dead due to heat-related causes after temperatures swelled up to 50 degrees Celsius in some parts of the country. Authorities confirmed Thursday the three-week-long heat wave claimed about 112 lives. The health ministry said nearly all fatalities were due to heat stroke, followed by dehydration. While the rainy season has brought in some cooler temperatures, authorities have also warned another heat wave may grip the country this July. Torrential rains in South Korea that triggered a landslide left a one-year-old baby dead and forced hundreds to flee their homes. The disaster left the baby's home in Yeongju City buried in mud. Rescuers say the infant died soon after being sent to a hospital. The death was the second since the summer rainy season began in South Korea. Yeongju City was among the hardest hit by the monsoon. Disaster officials have also declared heavy rain warnings in the south of the country, including the island of Jeju. Former U.S. Vice President Mike Pence meets with Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky in a surprise trip to Ukraine. Pence vowed to continue supporting Ukraine throughout the Russian conflict. He also visited three cities near the capital, Kyiv, to inspect damage from Russian shelling. Pence is the first Republican candidate to meet with Zelensky during the campaign period. He's taking on his former boss, then U.S. President Donald Trump, for the 2024 GOP nomination.
We need to make sure that we provide the Ukrainian military what they need to push back on and defeat Russian aggression here. Because it will make it clear to Russia, to China, and to any other nations in the world that would seek to redraw international lines by force, that the free world will not stand for it. The free world will stand together for freedom.
Meanwhile, Swedish climate activist Greta Thunberg meets with Ukrainian President Zelensky. Thunberg visited Kyiv Thursday to draw attention to the environmental damage caused by the war in Ukraine. There, she criticized the world's response to the June 6 collapse of the massive Kakhovka Dam, which left dozens of villages inundated and farmlands without irrigation. Ukraine is investigating the dam blast as a possible war crime and a so-called ecocide. The damage is estimated at 1.2 billion euros. And before we go, Filipino-American singer Olivia Rodrigo returns to the pop music scene. That's after she released her newest single, Vampire. In a tweet, the 20-year-old hitmaker said the song helped her sort through lots of feelings of regret, anger, and heartache. She adds it's now one of her favorite songs on her upcoming album, Guts, which will be released on September 8th. The Phil-Am singer bagged three awards in the 2022 Grammy Awards last April, including the coveted Best New Artist trophy.